For the entrance, let us take A73.
Today's Mass, we offer for the soul of Bento Caldera. We pray that he may find eternal rest. So also, I thank God today for the gift of life that he has given to me, as on this day I celebrated my baptism. I was given baptism, and this faith that I received on today, on this day, I ought to cherish it. I ought to live it in my life. And therefore, for having given me this gift of faith, I thank God. Let us also place our personal intentions for those who are celebrating their birthdays, their wedding anniversaries. And also let us pray for those who are sick, who are suffering, who are homebound, who are on bed rest. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear friends, today the liturgy, the readings are inviting us to stay firm in our faith, no matter what the condition, no matter what the circumstance. In other words, when we are strong in our faith, we can say that we are fruitful with what God has given us. God has given us a lot of talents. God has given us a lot of qualities which we ought to use for His greater glory. So in this Eucharistic celebration, as we partake, let us pray for ourselves that we may be able to use the qualities given by God for His greater glory, and to be fruitful in our faith, thus living a life pleasing to God. And for the times when we have failed to do so, when we have failed to put the qualities given by God to good use for His greater glory, when we have failed to realize the faith that is given to us, let us ask pardon from the Lord and prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God
and to my brothers and sisters that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have been to do, to my most grievous fault.
Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, by whose gift Saint Elizabeth of Hungary recognized and revered Christ in the poor, grant through her intercession that we may serve with unfailing charity the needy and those afflicted. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the second book of Maccabees. In those days it happened also that seven brothers and their mother were arrested and were being compelled by the king under torture with whips and cords to partake of unlawful swine's flesh. The mother was especially admirable and worthy of honorable memory, though she saw her seven sons perish within a single day. She bore it with good courage because of her hope in the Lord. She encouraged each of them in the language of their fathers. Filled with a noble spirit, she fired her woman's reasoning with a man's courage and said to them, "I do not know how you came into my being in my womb. It was not I who gave you life and breath, nor I who set in order the elements within each of you. Therefore, the Creator of the world, who shaped the beginning of mankind and devised the origin of all things, will in his mercy give life and breath back to you again, since you now forget yourselves for the sake of his laws." Antiochus felt that he was being treated with contempt, and he was suspicious of her reproachful tone. The youngest brother being still alive, Antiochus not only appealed to him in words, but promised with oaths that he would make him rich and enviable if he would turn from the ways of his fathers, and that he would take him for his friend and entrust him with public affairs, since the young man would not listen to him at all. The king called the mother to him and urged her to advise the youth to save himself. After much urging on his part, she undertook to persuade her son. But leaning close to him, she spoke in their native tongue as follows, deriding the cruel tyrant, "My son, have pity on me. I carried you 9 months in my womb and nursed you for 3 years and have reared you and brought you up to this point in your life and have taken care of you. I urge you, my child, to look at the heaven and the earth and see everything that is in them and recognize that not out of things that already existed did God make them. And so too the human race comes into being. Do not fear this butcher, but prove worthy of your brothers. Accept death, so that in God's mercy I may get you back again along with your brothers." Now, as she was speaking, the young man said, "What are you waiting for? I will not obey the king's command, but I obey the command of the law that was given to our fathers through Moses. But you, who have contrived all sorts of evil against the Hebrews, will certainly not escape the hands of God." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response: when I wake up, O Lord, I shall be filled with the vision of your presence. Please repeat.
When I wake up, O Lord, I shall be filled with the vision of your presence.
O Lord, hear a cause that is just. Pay heed to my cry. Turn your ear to my prayer. No deceit is on my lips. Response:
When I wake, O Lord, I shall be filled with the vision of your presence.
I kept my steps firmly in your paths. My feet have never faltered. To you I call, for you will surely heed me, O God. Turn your ear to me, hear my words. Response: When I awake, O Lord, I shall be filled with the vision of your presence. Guard me as the apple of your eye. Hide me in the shadow of your wings. As for me, in justice, I shall behold your face. When I awake, I shall be filled with the vision of your presence. Response.
When I awake, O Lord, I shall be filled with the vision of your presence.
Gospel acclamation. And appointed you that you should go and bear fruit, and that your fruit should abide, says the Lord.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke.
Glory be to you, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus proceeded to tell a parable because he was near to Jerusalem and because they supposed that the kingdom of God was to appear immediately. He said, therefore, a nobleman went into a far country to receive for himself a kingdom and then return. Calling 10 of his servants, he gave them 10 minas and said to them, engage in business until I come. But his citizens hated him and sent a delegation after him, saying, we do not want this man to reign over us. When he returned, having received the kingdom, he ordered these servants to whom he had given the money to be called to him, that he might know what they had gained by doing business. The first came before him, saying, Lord, your mina has made 10 minas more. And he said to him, well done, good servant, because you have been faithful in a very little, you shall have authority over 10 cities. And the second came, saying, Lord, your mina has made 5 minas. And he said to him, and you are to be over 5 cities. Then another came, saying, Lord, here is your mina, which I kept laid away in a handkerchief. And for I was afraid of you, because you are a severe man. You take what you did not deposit, and reap what you did not sow. He said to him, I will condemn you with your own words, you wicked servant. You knew that I was a severe man, taking what I did not deposit, and reaping what I did not sow. Why then did you not put my money in the bank, and at my coming I might have collected it with interest? And he said to those who stood by, take the mina from him and give it to the one who has the 10 minas. And they said to him, Lord, he has 10 minas. I tell you that to everyone who has more will be given, but from the one who has not, even what he has will be taken away. But as for these enemies of mine who did not want me to reign over them, bring them here and slaughter them before me. And when Jesus said these things, he went on ahead, going off to Jerusalem. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear friends, today this Gospel which we just heard, the narrative of the 10 coins, the 10 minas, the 10 talents, whatever you might call it, but this is a treasure that is given to these servants. This young man, he goes to become a king, to be appointed as a king, and while going, he hands over his treasure to his servants and he tells them to keep it safe, to multiply, to do some business with it. And these servants of his, the first one, what does he do? He does some merchandise on the coin, on the mina, and he gets more 10 of them. The second one, he also does some more business, maybe not as much as the first one, but he does some business and gets more 2 coins. Now, the third one, what does he do? He does not do any business, just keeps it in a handkerchief. Now, these are 3 kinds of people who are presented before us by Jesus. The first kind of person is the one who is given faith, a gift from God, and this person puts that faith to practice, lives that faith, and lives it to a great extent, glorifies God in the best way he can, tenfold. The second person also is working on the faith that is given to him, but maybe he can't do it to the extent that the first one does. So he multiplies it fivefold. And the third type of person is a person who has been given the faith but is living a very shallow life, a life that does not reap fruit. Jesus, when he tells us, "I am the real vine, you are my branches," in John chapter 15, he is telling us to be fruitful. And to be fruitful, we need to abide in him, to live in him. So this faith that was given to us on our baptism day is the faith that we ought to live, the faith that we ought to put to practice and be fruitful by abiding in Christ. Today in the first reading, we see the 7 sons of Maccabeus and his mother. Definitely, they were living a very pious life, a righteous life, a life pleasing to God, to an extent that they were ready to give up their life for the sake of the good news, for the sake of the kingdom of God, for the sake of their living God, Yahweh. And we see how these 7 sons, 6 of them were already killed, and the 7th one, when he is about to be killed, the king presents before the mother and tells her, gives her an offer. He tells her, "Your son, if you tell him, if you convince him," or he tells the son first, "that you will receive a good job, a good office in my courtyard. You will get a lot of money if you renounce your faith." And that time, the mother, he pleads her as well. "Just tell your son, see, he's wasting his life, about to be killed. See if you can convince him." And the mother, she convinces her son by doing some acting. She presents before the king that she is telling her son, but she speaks to him in the native language and tells her son that, "See, you have lived your faith. This is the faith given by your forefathers, the faith that is gifted by God. Do not waste it. Do not put it to waste, or do not just keep it like that, because he is going to give you rewards, because your reward is in heaven." So our reward is not on this earth. So if we are going to reap fruit with what God has given us and being fruitful, we need to be fruitful with the gifts or the treasure that is in store for us in heaven, and not the treasure of this world. This seventh son of Maccabeus, had he accepted the king's offer, he would be fruitful in the eyes of the world, but he would not be fruitful in the eyes of God. So like this seventh son, we are all of us called to be fruitful in order to do a merchandise of our faith. And this we can do when we live our faith and proclaim the good news, proclaim the gospel. So in this Eucharistic celebration, as we partake, let us pray for ourselves that we may be able to live our faith for the greater glory of God and be fruitful the way God wants us to be, and not the way we want to be or the world wants us to be. Amen.
For the offertory, kindly take B27. In bread we bring you, Lord.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Grant, O Lord, we pray, that what we offer in the sight of your majesty may obtain for us the grace of being devoted to you, and gain us the prize of everlasting happiness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For in the marvelous confession of your saints, you make your church fruitful with strength ever new, and offer us sure signs of your love, and that your saving mysteries may be fulfilled, their great example lends us courage. Their fervent prayers sustain us in all we do. And so, Lord, with the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim. Holy,
holy, holy, holy, holy Lord, Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world. For by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Philip Neri our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are we who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Spiritual Communion Prayer by Jesus. I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament of the altar. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into myself. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
For the communion, kindly take D18, Sing My Soul.
Pray. We have partaken of the gifts of this sacred mystery, humbly imploring, O Lord, that what your Son commanded to us to do in memory of him may bring us growth in charity. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
For the recessional, kindly take X3, To the World We Go.
Together.